Yo, what it do, 2K fans? It's your boy, Drew King, the boss, and we back once again. This time, we're talking about the VC guide. We're going to give you the complete guide to the best ways to earn VC. You want to get to 90 in 1 week without spending money on extra VC? You got to check these few things out. First of all, every day you want to do your daily spend. Now, when it comes down to it, daily spend has been really bad for me in the past week, for real. I've either been getting 1,000 my points or an item for a shoe brand that I don't have. So as you can see in this one, I'm going to get the Under Armour shoe brand, a deal, but I'm with Nike. So it doesn't really help me at all unless I just want to walk around the neighborhood with some Under Armour gear. Now, the next thing we're going to talk about is the badges. Progressing your badges is a couple of tricks that you need to learn going into it. So most of my badges are maxed out. I only got two badges left, two of my primary badges left to max out, and then some of my more emotional badges, or you know, the little blue crap badges that just kind of like buff you in certain situations in the game, microwave, things like that. But the best way to get these badges is look at the hardest badge it is for you to get. So my hardest badge for me to get was mid-range Deadeye. And so in the prelude, it's the best time to exploit getting that badge quicker, because you are rewarded better for your badges, but at the same time you also are playing on rookie. So essentially you're getting pro level or Hall of Fame level rewards on rookie level in the prelude. It's a way to kind of make you feel real good about your game, but it also gives you a chance to earn those badges a lot quicker. And so the badge that I worked on first was my mid-range Deadeye badge, because I didn't have my mid-range capped out yet. So even at overall 60, I was able to knock it down. And in order to get that badge, you gotta be shooting in people's face. So you pump fake, let them come to you, and then pull the trigger. Easiest time to get it is when the game is playing on rookie. So it's not too bad to get it on pro if you have the right jump shot. For my career, I do like to use the 49 base for it, because it is a little more fluid, it is a little more consistent, and I got a lot of my badges, my shooting badges, just using that base in my career. Corner specialist, catch and shoot, got that badge using just that base. But then, like I said, take advantage of your hardest badge to get. If you're a sharpshooter, you want to go for your limitless range badge in the prelude. You could also get your deep range Deadeye badge at the same time in the prelude. Utilize the prelude for those hard to get badges. Utilize practice for the other badges, such as charge card and chase down artists if you have that badge. Everything else you can kind of earn in game as you go along, and depending on what level you play on, that's going to depict on how easy or how hard it is for you to get those badges. Chase down artists is a badge that you can get a lot quicker playing on a level like All-Star, Superstar, or Hall of Fame, as opposed to pro, because the situation is going to come up more often. So the biggest thing for VC earning is your endorsements. Now, I've played around with these endorsements, and there are a couple of tips that you need to know going into negotiating your endorsements. Like with your contract, you want to get the best value for yourself. So I always went for the most VC I can get per event. Now, a lot of people will tell you that the VC won't really matter per event because you only get a couple of events per year. But if you look at my Gatorade, if you look at my Foot Locker, I'm getting max VC for Foot Locker. Now, I'm also getting 5 different in-game incentives. But here's a trick. If you're worrying about getting the maximum event cost, don't focus on the endorsements at all for us in-game incentives, because regardless of which level, if you choose no incentives, they're going to automatically give you incentives. You just won't be able to choose which incentives you get. Now, some people say that you might want to choose the incentives that you get, because at the end of the day, choosing the incentives that are easier for you is going to net you the easier amount of VC per game. But if you let it choose the incentives for the first couple of tiers, you got the best chance at moving your per event earnings up a lot quicker. And then those in-game incentives gives you something to push for to earn that little bit of extra. So you're improving the way you play, improving how you address each game, so that way you can get those in-game incentives. But at the same time, you're focused morely on every time one of those events come up, you can get 2,500. Every time one of those events come up, you can get 5,000. So it took me to my fourth level to get the max for Foot Locker. But now I'm at the max, which is level 5 for Foot Locker, and I have all, I got 5,000 per event. I got to choose my five in-game incentives, and at the same time, I got the 25% discount. And they offered that to me because the simple fact is that on my level 4 contract, I had already had 5,000 and I was already getting 20%. And I still chose no incentives, and they gave me 5 incentives. They just chose the 5 they gave me. But now with these 5 incentives, essentially my incentives are all based around scoring and blocks. I average 3 blocks a game. I average 3 steals a game. So essentially I'm gonna make an additional 265 VC just for playing, on top of my salary, on top of my bonus for stats, and on top of my bonus for my teammate grade. So essentially I'm earning about 2,500 a game with the Foot Locker incentives. And if I also push for my Gatorade incentives or my Nike incentives, then I'm earning even more. So I can earn about 3 grand per game. Now for Gatorade, there's some good incentives for Gatorade, but for Foot Locker, it was mainly based around points. And I guess it was because my man's a Shaq creator primary, defender secondary. And so as you can see, I went for a scoring VC, and I went for block VC. So now we're gonna take a look at Gatorade. Now Gatorade, I'm still one away from level 5. That's the next one I'm working on, 7.5 million fans. But as you can see already, I'm already at the max that I can get for Gatorade. So when I negotiated my last contract, my level 4 contract with Gatorade, I already at level 3 was getting 2,500 per event, and I had 4 incentives. And now the biggest thing for Gatorade is the boost. Now the boost is kind of broken right now because you're supposed to get 30 per day. Now I don't know if that's an in-game day or an actual every 24 hours. So essentially it wasn't working, and 2K is right now in the process of fixing it. When they fix it, that's when I'll care about it. But I wasn't worried too much about the boost, mainly because if you can go spin the wheel a day, you might get boost. And so I'm looking at it like, if I'm so busy focused on getting the max amount of boost as opposed to the max amount of VC that I can get per event, then essentially I'm negating the boost that I would earn spinning the wheel, because the boosts come up more often on the wheel spin than a lot of other things. So I told myself, I said, I'm gonna focus on getting the max deal. Looked and saw what it was even at level 1. The max I was able to get was 2,500. But at level 1, I had to settle for something a little smaller. So I settled with 1,500. 1,500, no boost, and no incentives. And they gave me the incentives. So they gave me 3 incentives to start. No, 2 incentives to start. And I just boosted that up from there once I got to the next level. But here was the tricky part. So essentially I had turned down Gatorade several times before arriving at the 1500 VC. Now by the time that I accepted the 1500 VC, because that's what I was trying to get with my level 1, by the time I accepted that, I had already done enough and gained enough fans to get to level 2. So essentially right after I got my level 1, they came back to the table again with level 2. And when they came back with level 2, I said, no, I want 2 grand minimum, and I wanted 12 boosts. Now they wanted to give me the 2 grand and they wanted to give me 6 boosts. I said, all right, I can go with that. But here's the best thing about it. When you're doing these deals, you can always turn them down and decline their final offer. Once you play your next game, they're gonna come back to the table again with another offer. And it's most likely gonna be the same low ball offer. Work on getting your fans up, because the more fans you get, the better you can come to the table with the offer. Your marketability represents how much they should be willing to pay you. So if your marketability is A-, A+, then focus on, hey, nah, I'm worth a lot. You know, I'm gaining fans, I'm moving, I'm pushing weight around this joint. So when it comes down to it, I want the best bang for my buck. So by level 2, I had a 2000 VC endorsement offer from them, and I had fun with that. So now we move on to Nike. And Nike, I still got 1 level left for Nike that I know of. I'm at level 4 now. and already I'm getting 6,000 per event. Now 6,000 was the max that I could get. I don't expect it to be able to go up any higher, but who knows when I hit that level five, what kind of extra deals I can get, what kind of extra incentives I can get. But right now I'm getting 6,000 per event, and then I got three incentives. Once again, did not choose my incentives. Why? Because this, when it comes down to your shoe deal, the incentives for shoe deals only count for TV games. So this is why for your shoe deal, focus on getting as much money as you can and getting a good high tier level shoe available to you for free. Now, when I started off my first sit down with them, I only cared about just getting level one shoes just so that way I can have me some Nikes to wear in the game. I didn't want to pay my VC to buy some shoes until I got high enough level. So I said, hey, look, I want the money. I'll take tier one shoes. I don't care about incentives. And they gave me three incentives. Like I said, these incentives only apply if I'm playing in a televised game. If I'm not playing in a televised game, them incentives don't apply. So essentially, don't fight for your incentives with Nike because, or don't fight for your incentives with your shoe deal in general, because you won't really get those unless you're playing in TV games. Now, and if you're playing for a team like Golden State, you might get more TV games throughout the course of the year, but I wasn't playing for a team like Golden State. I started off my season playing with the Pelicans and then went to the Wizards. And during that process, I'm looking at it like I'm not playing that many TV games, so I don't really care about my incentives for Nike, because even though they're big incentives, they're worth a lot, I'll get them when I get them. But essentially, by the time I hit level five with that, I'm gonna have the five incentives. I'm gonna get the best shoes for free for my career. And here's another thing, because the incentives aren't as good and the shoes are only for career, I really felt like I'm not really worried about it too much. So when you go in and your goal is to get the best value for your buck, a couple of things take into consideration. Foot Locker is going to give you a discount on shoes, but those shoes only apply to my career. It does not apply to park shoes and things like that. But any shoes that you buy for the park so far work for my career. Now, I don't know if that's a bug or something, but that's how it was for me. So always focus on getting the max per event, because even though events come around just a couple times, you really want to make sure that the incentive is that you get the best bang for your buck. As always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel. If you're new, turn on post notifications so you always catch each video the moment it comes out. And also check out one of the two videos you see on screen. This your boy, Jew King the Boss, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.